Hey, it's Mercedes with Frameless Media. Today we're discussing the finale of season 3, Raising Kanan. And we're going to pick up where we left off, and that's with the cliffhanger. We're all thinking that something bad was going to happen with Lou, and we see that Lou is now at a rehab facility, finally. We are finally dealing with his binge drinking. Now, during the visit, he's now able to have a therapy session. Rock was invited, and we can see now the dynamic of their relationship. Now, keep in mind, they're siblings, but the way they act is more like mother and son. But the best thing of it, out of it all was that at the end, Rock was able to apologize for her wrongdoing, and Lou was finally able to accept some type of accountability for his actions. Now, later we do see Rock dealing with some more consequences of her actions, and that's with the fact that she cut the supply of Ronnie and Kanan, and that was met with some gunfire. And that happened in broad daylight. It spooked her, it scared her. And one thing I gotta say is, how is it that Rock and Marvin are moving around with no bodyguards? Have y'all noticed that? Snaps and Pops, they got a crew, they got hitters. And here it is, Rock and Marvin, they just moving solo dolo. So not too sure why the writers didn't think of that, but yeah, Rock, her solution to all of this is to get Marvin to go talk to Snaps and Pops and try to cause some type of truce. They ain't trying to hear all of that. Sorry, but a war has now been started. We do see later Jukebox and Aisha having a moment. Aisha finally comes clean about her feelings for Jukebox, but it's kind of too late because Jukebox is just ready to leave. She's joined the military. So Detective Howard, he's kind of at the end of this road too, and we saw that towards the end of the episode. His back is in a corner now. Police are investigating more, and they're starting to put two and two together. They start to question him about his whereabouts, some of the wrongdoings that he did, and they're starting to kind of realize that there might be a connection between him and the Thomas family. So they suspend him until further investigation is done. But meanwhile, Detective Howard's solution to that is by convincing Rock to try to get Marvin to take the fall for it, and she ain't buying it. Now, in the midst of all of this, Kanan gets news from Famous that a shooting took place, that his mom might have been injured. Now, this is where things get fuzzy. It's kind of hard to see what's real and what's not real. So he's upset, but then we start to see more of his anger when he bum rushes Ronnie at the restaurant. But then later, we soon realize that he's kidnapped, but then at the end, we see that all of this was just a setup. So not too sure what was real and what wasn't. But now that we're at the end, we have Rock and Detective Howard, Ronnie, and Kanan. So it's a standoff now. And just when you think Ronnie has the upper hand, Kanan pulls a gun and gets rid of Ronnie, and Rock does the same to Detective Howard. So now you have two dead bodies in a warehouse. And to make things even better is when Unique shows up on the screen. So this whole time I kept thinking that he has to still be alive because he's a fan favorite. Why get rid of a fan favorite? People were threatening to stop watching this show. And I was one of them, because without Unique, there is no Raising Kanan. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry. But overall, I give the finale a definite 10 out of 10. Glad to see Unique is back. I'm looking forward to season 4. But just some key takeaways. Crystal being pregnant, who's the baby daddy? Also, Famous being arrested, not too sure how long he's gonna, you know, withhold this tough guy image that he's holding. Like, he's trying to be quiet and want to talk to a lawyer, but I feel like later on he's gonna end up snitching. And also too, what happens with Kanan and Rock? Like, are they back teaming up together? And then also Unique, with him back on the scene, is he taking Ronnie's spot? Is it gonna be a Ronnie, not Ronnie, I'm sorry. Is he taking Ronnie's spot? Is there gonna be a Unique versus Rock? Like, what's the dynamics of their relationship? But overall, great finale. Looking forward to season 4. Make sure you leave a comment, like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys for another review.